Hello, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today we're going to run through the 10 commandments of learning scales. Now, these are 10 things that you should or shouldn't be doing when studying scales on the guitar if you're wanting to develop your best playing ability and have the most musical success with scales. So let's get right into the first one. Thou shalt always map the fingerboard. Now, as we all know, scales operate within keys, and keys all have a tonic or root note of the key. That's the key's naming note. If you don't know where the root naming notes are all over the neck, you will not understand where all the positions can be for playing any of the scales. So you can't forget or neglect to map the scale root notes all across the fingerboard. If you don't know how to do this, watch my lesson titled "Do This Every Single Day and Master Your Neck." It's one of the most well-organized and easy to follow videos that's posted on YouTube for teaching the basic principles of mapping out the notes on your neck. All right, number two is thou shalt include all 12 key signatures in scale practice. The great thing about mapping the neck is when it comes down to practicing any scale-based melody, if you move the idea through all 12 keys, it can be an excellent way to hit every scale's root note. Plus, it also helps guitar players readjust the intervals found in scales or riffs or licks for when the idea gets moved to any other musical key. Now, this means that the key signature practice can be a very powerful way to get good at learning new melody lines and to become extremely proficient at improvisation. If you don't understand your keys, what they do, and how they get used in music, then watch my video on YouTube titled "Over 40 and Still Don't Know Music Theory." That video and its lesson plan thoroughly review the ideas and the application of all 12 musical keys. The third commandment is thou shalt never play scales sloppy. Guys, if you ignore flubbed notes and you aren't taking steps to correct messy guitar technique, please stop and establish a plan to fix this as soon as possible. Good playing technique is especially important because badly played notes will also cause other problems, especially rhythmic problems, and it'll cause your feel for a song to actually degrade. And when it comes to fixing bad technique, you have to have a number of choices because I've produced several YouTube video lessons that provide a lot of options for correcting bad habits. I've made dozens of videos on this channel that are directed at playing smoother and cleaner notes, with one of the most popular ones being my lesson titled "The Spider Walk Exercise." The spider walk is a fantastic exercise that will go a long way to fixing your bad coordination habits. And if you'd like to take things a step further, you can also try studying my complete guitar technique course in the members area. The fourth commandment is thou shalt learn thy scales in every area of the neck. In all of my years teaching people how to play guitar, if there's one thing that guitar players tend to do over and over again, it's neglect learning how to play a scale, a lick, or a riff all over the entire guitar fingerboard. In fact, one of the most common things that players will do is they'll learn a riff or a lick from a scale and then leave it in the one single place that they learned the idea. So when you learn a guitar part, take that idea to at least two other locations on the guitar fretboard. That way you'll know it in three places. Later you could expand it to a fourth if you want to, but at least get to know them in three. I explained this system in detail on my YouTube video titled "System for Fretboard Association." Watch that video if you need more direction with taking ideas to other fret locations. I still have more commandments to go over with you, but I wanted to take just a minute to let you know that if you need to learn more about the basics, you know, keys and scales and harmony and all that stuff in different bar chord shapes and ideas, then I'm going to make you a great offer. With any donation over $5 or any purchase made from my Teespring store, I'll send you a free collection of some of my most popular digital handouts. One of them is called Harmonized Arpeggio Drills. It's a great handout that trains you on developing your diatonic arpeggios. Another one is my bar chord and keys handout, which is really nice. It's showing all the key signatures. It's got an explanation of the music theory for them. It's got chord progression in there for training you on bar chords. It's a fantastic handout. Plus, you're also going to get one of the most popular things around here. It's my notation pack. It's 8 pages of blank guitar worksheets for notating anything related to music charts, guitar chord diagrams, and tab. Plus, I'm going to send you an additional 5 bonus handouts as well. It's just some interesting stuff related to past videos that I put up here on YouTube. So once you make your donation or merchandise purchase, just send me an email off the contact page at creativeguitarstudio.com to let me know that you've done that, and I will email you those digital handouts within 24 hours. Well, the 5th commandment is thou shalt include time for fun with scales. You know, you have to always keep in mind that scales are the device that we use to create music with. We stack the scale tones to create chords and harmony, and we align the scale tones to create interesting ways to form melodies. It's really important that you have fun with them. So there needs to be a period that you spend with the scales that are, you know, just for practicing in a fun sense. You know, some musicians call this type of practice woodshedding or noodling or wandering around the neck with the notes musically. It doesn't matter what you call it. The important thing is you just absolutely have to do it, because fooling around with the scale and having fun with the musical sounds that it can create is going to get you the feel together for actually applying the notes and that make up using the scale in musical ways. Well, the 6th commandment is always honor the feel of the beat in time. And this one can be especially bad with beginner and intermediate guitar students. And it's important to understand that the feel of the beat has to do with the long-term development of what many musicians will often just call the body's inner sense for timing. And although some musicians get timing down quite nicely, sometimes early on in their practice days, other musicians can either be quite bad at it and need a lot of work at it with their sense of time getting better, you know, as they practice, or they can be the opposite altogether. You can have people that are pretty good and they end up just moving more and more towards perfectionism, and you know, that's fine too. And in fact, I'd almost say that's a better way to go about it. The perfectionist will tend to work, you know, for hundreds if not thousands of hours trying to master their sense for time, always finding new ways to get better at, you know, getting into the beat and playing over top of a harmony and nailing chord tones, things like that. So just perfecting every area of their performance. And you know, my suggestion is to do your best to become a musician like that. You know, strive for constant perfection when it comes to your sense of timing, and do it for everything that you play. Well, the 7th commandment is you shall not neglect the significance of duration. Now, if I were to pick one thing that a student who is new to the world of either composing or improvising with scales will seem to do over and over, is that they will play their phrases with the same duration and style and not even realize they're doing it. Now, if you don't know what duration does, it's the core of your musical ebb and flow. See, the duration is the length of time notes are held. When they get sustained, they create phrases, which are called the musical meter of the piece. So duration is a concept of feel and time that produces the perception and the reflex of the music being composed or improvised. Duration is responsiveness to the notes of the scale that you're working with. So learn how to pay attention to the use of your 8th notes and your 16th notes and your triplets and syncopation and things like odd meter, so that the feel and the flow of what you play will be interesting and unique, because without good control over duration, your music's feel will suffer. The 8th commandment is do not favor any one area of the neck over another. Now, this is not just a problem for scales, it's a problem for chords as well. Too often, students of the guitar will play songs or play a solo in only one or maybe 2 areas of the neck, and I can fully understand this. It all comes down to how familiar you feel with the neck, and there's nothing wrong with that as you're learning your way around the instrument, but your goal should be to improve and stretch your knowledge for keys and scales, every place on the guitar neck so that one day you'll be able to play your musical ideas all over the neck with your knowledge plus your understanding for scales in the fretboard, and you'll become more versatile. Like, for instance, if you were playing a solo in the key of D minor, your long-term goal in, you know, that key or any other key should be to view the whole guitar neck as one big friendly place and to be able to perform your songs and your solo anywhere on the neck, no matter what key that you're performing music in. The ninth commandment is honor thy skill and thy application for phrasing. When we explore the scale phrasing skills of any famous player, there's always one thing that they'll have in common with each other, and that's their ability to phrase lines in a way that presents the idea that they're performing so that it comes across highly musical. Now, this skill allows the melodies or the harmonies that are being created to really connect with the audience. You know, phrasing, good phrasing, is the ability that a musician has worked on for many years. It doesn't come easily. And over time, we develop within ourselves the ability to take any scale into a musical statement and connect that statement into another one in a very unique and individual way. And every player does this differently with phrasing devices. They'll use, you know, slides and bends and vibrato, trills, sweeps, legato. All this stuff gets used in a way that makes the music highly memorable for the listener. So work on your skills for both these devices and for your musical ability to help you phrase in a more memorable way. And remember, we do this work for all those who will be listening to our music, so it's important. Well, our last of the 10 commandments for learning scales is this one. Remember to faithfully honor your jam sessions. And it's important to note here that a jam session can be really anything from practicing a scale against a backing track that you either pulled up or created in GarageBand or something like that, or it could be a worked out composition that you've organized using several scales around different keys and different tonalities. Maybe it's just, you know, jamming with your friends on a Saturday afternoon on the front porch, or, you know, it could even be a weekend blues jam at your town hall or something like that. Whatever it is, you've just got to go and jam these scales and put them into action. It's critical to do this. The only way that these scales will eventually become second nature is when you use them to create music. If you don't use them, you'll forget them. And we don't want that to happen. So get out there, use these scales, apply them in musical ways, and before you know it, all your scales will become second nature, and you'll be able to apply them very easily in any musical situation. Guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including everything I talked about here in written form, then head down to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and your thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.